Hello, I'm Tara Alderete, Director of Enterprise Learning at Money Management International, a full-service nonprofit credit counseling organization. According to the Eviction Lab, an estimated 3.6 million evictions are filed each year. If you are at risk for eviction, it's important to assess your situation and options and identify resources that may be available to help. Federal, state, and local programs have provided different types of financial assistance amid the COVID-19 pandemic, including housing assistance and rental eviction moratoriums. While a moratorium is in effect, covered residents cannot be evicted, but proceedings can be initiated to move forward with eviction once the moratorium expires. The federal CDC eviction moratorium has been extended to June 30th, 2021, and some states and local ordinances may choose to offer further extended protection. So check with your local or state housing authority or Department of Community Affairs to find out if there are extended protections where you live. You can also visit nolo.com for a state-by-state protections guide. And the American Rescue Plan Act, signed into law in March of 2021, provides additional money for housing relief and assistance programs. So research those options with your housing authority or Department of Community Affairs as well. Residents must qualify to take advantage of moratoriums and other assistance programs. Eligibility is based on your situation and could include income requirements, hardship situations, and efforts to utilize other available program resources. If you qualify for the CDC moratorium, you'll have to sign a declaration and give it to your housing provider. The Eviction Protection Declaration can be found on the CDC website. Visit cdc.gov and search Eviction Protection Declaration. Send this and any other required documents via certified mail to prove they were received. It's also a good idea to prepare documentation that supports your situation in case it's required, and keep copies of everything for your own records. If you're having trouble making payments or facing possible eviction, communicate with your landlord or housing provider as soon as possible. You may be eligible for assistance in the form of reduced or suspended payments, late payment plans, or other options. Pay as much of your regular payment as possible, keeping in mind that unpaid rent or mortgage may have to be paid when moratoriums expire or repaid on some payment plans. You may be able to fight an eviction order, so stay in your home or apartment if possible, and attend your eviction hearing, prepared with relevant information and documentation, including any payments you've made. Seek help if you need it. Low-cost and free legal services may be available, so check with the Legal Aid Society where you live. And initiatives like evictionlab.org and the National Law Housing Project provide tenant resources and information all in one place. Finding yourself in a situation where you're unable to make payments or facing possible eviction can be scary, especially in uncertain times. But you're not alone. Here are some resources that could help. Visit nationalevictions.com to learn tenant eviction rights, the eviction process in your state, and to find resources in each state. HUD.gov provides information on rental and housing assistance. cfpb.gov/housing, nhlp.org/COVID-19, and evictionlab.org offer help for renters and homeowners during the COVID emergency and beyond. And to connect with a certified housing counselor, contact us at moneymanagement.org. Thank you for joining me to learn more about this important topic. For additional financial wellness topics or to schedule a counseling session, give us a call at 866-889-9347 or visit us online today.